Hey, hey, everyone. Good morning. It is Kara Presley, and you are now listening to the Kara Presley Radio Show. I'm super excited to get started today. Today, we have another powerhouse joining us for an interview. Y'all stay tuned, and we'll be back with the next voices you'll hear, Kara Presley and Tammy Mobley. All right, everybody. We are back. It's Kara Presley, and I'm joined with Tammy Mobley. How are you, Tammy?
Good, busy, tired.
Tammy is the founder of Real Girls. Tammy, tell us what Real Girls is, because I don't want to mess up the acronym. What is Real Girls?
So Real Girls are responsible, empowered, and loved. Real Girls are responsible for their actions in their homes and the community. They're empowered to use their voices, and they're loved not only by their immediate family, but now they're part of our Real Girls family. And if anybody sees our Instagram page, our Facebook page, you know we shower them with love. So Real Girls is an empowerment program that provides safe spaces for girls to develop, for the girls to foster healthy relationship skills, develop leadership skills, and believe in their greatness.
I love that. I mean, you know, we see people all the time helping girls or helping kids, but the one thing that sets you apart is, I was like, is this a nonprofit? And you were like, oh no, we are for profit. I feel like some people are afraid to say that, but your program is in several schools and programs. Can you tell everyone where are you helping out in the community?
Right. Since January, we have been in Richmond and Henrico County Public School. So Armstrong High School, which you were part of. Yes. Armstrong High School is actually part of our Trauma Healing Response Network. So that is part of the Virginia Department of Health. They fund that program. Okay. Through Next Up RVA, we are in Henderson Middle School, Albert Hill Middle School, Lucia Brown, and River City. Middle school. And then in Henrico, through Henrico Education Foundation, we are in Fairfield's Wilder Middle School, and we were in Elko that finished. So it was a total of 10 programs that we were doing from January. So it's been really busy for us. And my weekend program, we have a leadership weekend program for high school girls.
Oh, I love that. I mean, because I've seen girls graduate from your program and go on and just, I mean, it's just such a great rounded group of girls. But I think it's more so the fact that it's like a family, like really a family. There are a lot of groups who will, they'll come in and they'll make you feel good for a day and then they kind of leave. But you're long lasting. Was that intentional?
To be honest, I didn't even think it was going to even be this long. Like when I started, I lost my job as a youth program director, and I would say I'm not even going to work with youth anymore. But I feel like that's my calling because that's what people know me as. And I started at Chesterfield Career and College Academy, Carver Career College Academy. Okay. And I had that one program, and they said, we're gonna give you a try, Tammy. I said, okay. And I had maybe about 10 girls, and actually one of the girls there, she still comes back as part of her Real Girls now. She was in the 11th grade. Now she's a sophomore in college. So I had that. Then my other contract was with James River Detention Center. So I went, and then I did that, and then COVID hit. So I kind of like shut everything down. But Next Up was like, Tammy, let's do virtual. And I did virtual the whole time during COVID. And I think that's what really was able to have me to elevate, because a lot of people had to shut down. And what I did was I created activity packages, and I would drive all over Richmond and drop off activity packages. So when we were virtual, they were able to go in their package and say, today we're baking a cake, and they would pull out their cake stuff. Today we're going to paint, and they would pull out their painting stuff. And that's exactly how Real Girl just started elevating. And now you're right. You said everybody's part of Real Girl's family. You are too.
I am too. Yes, I am. I've done guest speaking. I've come to visit the girls in the summer. I'm gonna come back this summer. Yes. So I love anywhere I can share a story. I think that's, you know, it's just helping a holistic approach to helping people. It's not just for the kids, it's for the adults too. Adults have a good time with Real Girls. So yes. I love that.
We're known as a hype program because there's so many girl programs out there. So I usually tell people we're known as a hype program. And someone asked me recently, they said, well, how do you get those girls? Like, I see them, like, they really want to be in your program. Like, we're not pulling girls, and they just so energetic. And I said, you know what? Who gravitates to me? I said, we have fun in there, but I'm not always like, even though I am hype most of the, like, in there, but it's just part of them. Like the girls that come in there, like some, we had a photo shoot, mm-hmm. and while we were preparing for the photo shoot, they were in the corner dancing.
Like, and so it's just always dancing.
Yeah. So I think it's whoever just, those are the girls that just gravitate to be a real girls. And then we just form that, like, just hypeness.
Just the connection. I love, I mean, it's the authentic connection for me as well. I love that. You know, you said you were known as a youth director, but I mean, I'm sure there's more to Tammy Mobley. I know that there's more to Tammy Mobley. You have a radio show, you have a lot of other things going on, but tell everyone who you are and maybe what do you see next in your evolution? What's next in your career? And then we'll talk about your mental health event coming up.
Yeah, so I don't know if you know or other people know, but I'm the United States of Women Ambassador for Virginia. And that was, it's formed under the Obama administration. So we have ambassadors all over the United States and we fight for gender equality, gender equity, and things like that. So I really would like to go ahead and focus a little bit more on that part of, you know, just my domestic violence stuff. Even though I have the radio show, it's like I'm there, but I really want to get onto a higher level with it. Maybe in the political stuff, you know,
to go ahead.
Yeah, like I really would like to do that. I'm also on the Leadership Council for Virginia Sexual and Domestic Action Alliance. Okay. And actually there's a retreat coming up and we're considered voices. We are the voices of survivors. And we're one of the keynote speakers for the retreat that's coming up in Harrisburg in June. So those are the things that I probably don't talk enough about or even talk about it. People just know me as Real Girls on the radio show, but there's so many other things that I do that I want to bring to the forefront and then let some things go. Like the radio show, I'm starting to let that go. And I know we spoke before we started, said, you know, there's a season for everything. And my season there was for 3 years, but it's time for me to go ahead and show the other things that I do that people don't know that I'm doing.
I love that though. I mean, because letting go is a big part of not just entrepreneurship, but life. And the sooner we accept that, the sooner we can really allow into our spaces what's meant for us. But let's talk a little bit about love, because I know you're married. Tell us how is entrepreneurship and being married? Maybe someone out there needs to hear a positive word about just pushing through it, or, you know, I've seen him support you so successfully. Yeah. How has life been? In that capacity,
it's been different because we're empty nesters also, so just trying to navigate all of those worlds. My husband, he just got actually a promotion on his job, so he's going to be traveling a little bit. He got a dog. I'm an entrepreneur, so it's just like so many other things that you're trying to like, okay, and then still trying to find time for a vacation. And I think it was just this week, he said, hey, let's go to Tennessee. And I'm like, well, what's in Tennessee? Like, I don't know. Like, I'm only thinking about sitting on the beach, right?
Right.
He's like, well, we could do other things too. So just trying to do all of that, still trying to be a wife, still trying to be a mom. My son is out of state.
You know,
he's 3 hours away. So still trying to be there for him, trying to still check in with him. So it's just actually trying to find balance. That's what our mental health awareness event is, finding balance when you feel unbalanced. Mm-hmm. And I named it that because I was actually feeling a little bit unbalanced. I was feeling a little bit burnt out being in all the schools that I'm in. April 1st, one of my childhood best friends passed away from cancer. And still having to deal with the grief, still having to be the face of Real Girl, still having to be a wife, still having to be a mom, still dealing with my clients. It was still trying to find that balance. So that's kind of like how that came together with the mental health awareness event.
Okay. Well, thank you for sharing that. And sorry for your loss, because I think that's another part of just life as well. We don't necessarily stop and talk about the grief or share the grief. And I don't know if it's because we don't want to hear the, oh, I'm sorry. I think there's just an initial automatic response for people to just say they're sorry, but that may help us through, or staying busy can help us through experiencing grief, being married and being an empty nester. Do you feel the need to like fill up your space? This is just a transparent question, just as a person. I sometimes feel the need to fill up my space. Like, let me find something new.
You know what? Being busy is actually a trauma response, right? So that's actually a trauma response. And I had to learn that also. I had to learn that through therapy. I had to learn, and all of these things, right? Just learning that is a trauma response, is because we fill up something because we don't want to deal right? Mm-hmm. So we keep ourselves busy so we don't have to deal with some other stuff. So that's another reason why I'm learning to like let things go and just live in the moment and then take that time. Because even when my friend died, like it was really hard for me. Even and I was still showing up on social media. I was still showing the radio. But I was in two meetings and I broke down crying in the meetings that I went to. Even the meeting for me to secure the place for the mental health event, like I was in there and I was just like, oh, I was just crying. It was like, tell me what happened. And it was like, I just couldn't hold it in anymore. And so it's just really, you know, not trying to be that busy that you don't even have time to grieve. And I felt like that's what was happening. I kept running in addition to other projects. Like I worked with Prison Rape Elimination Act. Like I was in the jails working, doing things on sexual assault. So it's so much stuff that was happening, but I wasn't giving myself the opportunity to grieve. So I would say, don't be so busy that you put stuff in that you neglect your mental health.
That part. You know, I definitely realized the last year that I had to unlearn the busyness. Like you say, like it's a trauma response, and my trauma was from the workplace. I was definitely the only African American at work and definitely constantly questioned about what are you doing? You know what I mean? So being on my own and like setting my own schedule and enjoying this entrepreneurship life, I had to like tell myself, like, you are not being lazy. You deserve a nap, you know? So I acquired a
or
nap.
Two.
Right. Every day, okay? I acquired a nice nap ministry and I got so much more done in the season of rest than I ever thought I could have, you know what I mean? So I am back busy actually. And like you said, it's a trauma response. Sometimes I have to tap in and say, girl, you trying to hide from something else? What else is going on? But I am all over the place. One of the
you
places-
are. I remember I texted you the other day. I said, girl, I seen you somewhere. Every time I go on the media, I see a flyer. I was like, Cara, President, career cheerleader, hosting this event.
Six flyers.
And you're hosting my event too, right?
Right, exactly. And let's talk about your event. This mental health event is next week. I'm going to be the MC. I'm excited about it. I love to talk and MC, so I'm okay with being on all these flyers. But you also have some spoken words. You got some good panelists coming. Tell us really what to expect in next week's event and how people can come out, because it's free, right?
It is a free event and it is sponsored by City of Richmond Positive Youth Development. And so they give us a mini grant and we're doing that. It's also sponsored by Richmond Police Department. Like they have been big sponsors, like getting the location and everything. We will have actually a police officer on the panel. So because we want to find out, you know, we hear a lot of stuff in the news about police reacting to someone that has a mental health issue or event. So she's going to be sharing information about that. We have Dr. Candace Venus on there. That's going to be because we want somebody that's a professional, because I'm not a therapist.
Right.
So we want somebody that's going to be on it, a therapist. We have Loretta Marshall, whose mother died by suicide when she was 13 years old, but no one ever told her that's how her mom died. She didn't find out until she was much older. Cyrus Dixon, who is a suicide attempt survivor. And then we have Rory Spencer, who is a student at BCU. So she's going to talk about some of the issues that she's had mentally and dealing with that. The panel actually going to be moderated by Jermel Spady, who is a licensed social worker, clinical therapist as well. Khalil Houston, he's going to be speaking spoken word. I'm hoping that he share a little bit of his story. And then we're also going to have a little ribbon ceremony, because I did not even know that there's different ribbons that symbolize like anxiety, depression, and things like that. So we're going to have that as well. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm excited about the ribbons because I don't think I knew either. I think I've only seen the purple for domestic violence awareness. So
yeah, I think it's green for mental health awareness, but I did not realize. And I think yellow is like you lost someone to suicide. So Loretta's going to she's educating me on that because I did not know about that.
Yes, educate us on the ribbons. We're going to come back and tell us what those ribbons mean.
And then you will be the host. You'll be able to do all this stuff. And so hopefully I could just move around.
Enjoy the event.
Yes. Oh, and we're going to have Miss Virginia U.S. International there. She's going to have a table because she is actually the official spokeswoman for Real Girls. So she sometimes comes out to events and she just talks about Real Girls. And it's just so amazing how she became a part of Real Girls family, because Real Girls were participating in the parade. And I just said, hey, can we take a picture with you? And that's how it just all started. But she is also a suicide attempt survivor. So, you know, just everyone that's just coming together. And again, finding balance when you feel unbalanced.
That part, that's so important that people, some people know my story about why I say I'm successful, because I felt suicidal at one point, and I was telling everyone I'm okay. The normal response is, how you doing? I'm okay. And I was not okay. And I was saying I was okay, because you don't know if you should break down crying, like you were saying earlier. Do you have capacity to even hear how I'm really doing? And for me, because I still didn't want to explain to others, I started saying, I'm successful, because I define my success every day. And that's just so important. I felt like it was a part of adulthood that no one really shared. You just kind of go from kid to adult, and no one really gives you space to share how you really are or say what's really going on. We're really just kind of moving through life. And when do we get time to slow down and just say, hey, I'm not doing well? How do you respond if someone said they're doing something other than okay? So that's where my successful came from. Y'all should use it. So then you can define it for yourself.
I'm successful.
Right. And success, sometimes it looks like Netflix all day, and sometimes it looks like 5 events in one day. It just depends on the day, but I'm definitely going to rest. And I love the stories of suicide survival, because no one wants to end their life. They want the pain to end, whatever that pain may be. And that's something we need to share a lot more. I have a coworker very, very close to me who passed from suicide. And it was his story. He went to work on a regular day with his wife and went right back home. And like, he had planned it. And it's just hard to see that people have planned certain steps when they execute it like that. So it's an interesting subject for me, and I'm just happy to be a part and be able to help you, man, and push this through.
Happy you're going to be there. It's been a long time coming, but I think the timing is right. It's May is Mental Health Awareness Month. It's going to be at Bird Park Roundhouse, 11 to 2:30. Again, it's a free event. We're really trying to put things together, but mostly we wanted to make sure it's a safe space. Like, I use safe spaces in everything on my radio show with my girls. I want to make sure that it's a safe space that people feel comfortable sharing, but not feel pressured to share, because we are going to have, like, afterwards, like a Q&A if anyone want to speak to anyone about anything that's going on with them. So I'm hoping and praying, and it will be a great safe space.
Don't be successful. I believe it already. I already know it is. And I actually learned the term safe space from you. Like, I knew that that's what I was trying to create in everything that I did. And I was like, yeah, I have a virtual safe space with my Red Table Talk group. So yeah, I love the term safe spaces. And I think those are the people I gravitate to as well. Like, anyone who creates a safe space, especially in Richmond, something other than just a place to spend money. I love you pop-up shops, exactly. But we need something to do. Express some words out here. So I appreciate
you. To work on our mind, mentally, emotionally, like, it's a lot. I think with you and I, because we are busy and people see us all the time, and they see us like, hey, you know,
I am right.
But then, and I don't think people even realize, like, how much goes into even just a little event like this, right? You know, just go into the planning and stuff. So when I get a phone call and they say, well, you didn't respond back in the
sorry, I had to move on. I just had to move on.
I'm managing 10 people in schools. I'm doing this, I'm doing that. So I think all of that, again, trying to find that balance, but people don't see what's going on in the back. They just see you surface and thinking like, oh, okay, yeah, like, she just got it together. But really, I don't have it together all the time.
It's right. And what does having it together look like and feel like? And what could it be? I just launched this membership series where I'm going to be training people all the time, but not your typical training. Thank you. And one of my first classes is emotional intelligence and emotional etiquette, because we think that because we're upset or going through it or angry, if I respond, that's just the way I am, or that's the way it is, versus are there other ways you could respond, or how does it feel to other people? Like, really just being intentional and aware of how your emotions look on the outside, you know, because they come off wrong, y'all. We need to change that before we end up mean and surly, you know, like, that's what we don't want to end up that.
or take that time. Like, I'm a person that I take time to self-isolate. Yeah. So I could be like, I'm in groups with my friends and stuff, and they're like, Timmy, what happened? I was like, I just need a moment, because even though everybody sees me out, I'm really not an extrovert. Like, I could be in my house, like, chill all day long with the book, with my robe, with my scarf on, my real girl's bonnet. And I could just be in the house all day, and I got to just go ahead and switch and, you know, be lively again. Right. So I just be like, you know what? I just need a moment. Like, when I'm around a lot of people, I need time to...
That part. Yeah, yeah. The COVID.
Yeah, fill my cup again, and then I'm able to get back out.
That part, COVID showed me, you don't have to be on all the time. And although I was very much good at it, and it is who I am, cutting it off is just so rewarding. I just, yeah. And I already didn't have a problem being by myself, but the additional COVID time being by myself just had me say, do I need to go out to this event today? Maybe not. Maybe right. not. Thank you, COVID.
I mean, you and I be texting like, did you get an invite to this? Did you see this?
Right. Are we going? I don't know. Yeah. I don't think I'm going, friend.
Yeah.
I went last year. Whatever right. that means, right? I've had the experience.
That was so, a season. Yeah.
New things. Yeah. This time, right? Nothing wrong with that. Listen, that's really all I had, Tammy. I just appreciate you for coming on and having this candid conversation to catch up with you and be on the Cara Presley Radio Show. I appreciate you.
Tell
everyone where they can follow you and continue watching The Real Girls Journey and the Tammy Mobley Journey.
Yes, well, you can follow me on Instagram. Instagram, my personal one is Tammy M. Mobley. You can follow me there. But Real Girls, r.e.a.l_girls with a Z. You'll see us. Like, it's all over. There's no way you cannot see a real girl.
Not going to miss it.
You will see us. And for the 2023-2024, we are planning to be in more schools. So if anyone wants to do a workshop, please let me know. If you want to work with me, please let me know. It's a lot.
Not a problem. And then Saturday's event is at the Roundhouse.
Yeah, Bird Park Roundhouse. It is free. Come on in, get some, listen to Cara Presley, listen to the panel, get some spoken words. I think we're going to have somebody trying to get refreshments and everything. Oh, and I will be on NBC 12 next week to promote the event. It's going to be a mental health event going on NBC 12, and I will be
okay. So catch you on the news talking all about the event, and then catch us on Saturday. We will be right there. I appreciate you so much, Tammy. Thank you again. Okay. Y'all stay tuned.
Have a good day.
Oh man, did you guys enjoy that interview with Tammy Mobley? I had an amazing time chatting with her, just listening to another perspective in business. I hope you guys enjoyed that interview. Listen, remember, you can catch me on carapresley.com. Go ahead and save that website right now so you know exactly where I am. Before we close out the show, you already know I'm going to bring you a few affirmations, successful affirmations. Shout out to my previous podcast host, Tracy T. Rowe, for her box of affirmations. Everyday amazing affirmations. I'm going to read about maybe six or so, just to help you start your day off. I hope you guys feel successful as your day continues after this episode. But I hope you have everything you need. So let's get into these affirmations. I will overcome this obstacle, and you will. I will share my love and light, as you should. I am unstoppable. Who feels like they're unstoppable today? I'm going to make good choices. I am working on myself for myself, not for anybody else. Y'all remember that. I know mistakes are lessons. Yes, don't beat yourself up. I will show up for myself. I am going to achieve this goal. Yes, listen, what goals do you have out there? What goals do you want to achieve? Who do you want to be? I encourage you to ponder that on today and really determine it for yourself. One of the goals that I wanted to achieve recently was to launch an on-demand training site, and not just a training site that taught things like customer service or people skills or just speaking, even though I do have a public speaking masterclass as well. I wanted to develop on-demand training that was like the continuing professional education training, but also personal and professional topics. And now I can fully announce that that training is available. My successfully launched website is up, and it is called the Mastermind Membership. When you go to carapresley.com, you can read all about the membership. Oh, it's just such an amazing site. I'm super excited about it. It is a site for people like you and me who don't want to do it all alone, who are tired of striving and trying to find the answers all by themselves, for people who just want to learn along the way, people who are lifelong learners along the way. The membership is $30 a month, and you can also come out with me on June 4th at the park and enjoy the Mastermind Brunch. Maybe you don't want to sign right up. Maybe you just want to learn a little bit more about it before you sign up. If that's the case, join me for brunch on June 4th. But let me give you a rundown of the classes, the first six classes that we'll be launching in May, June, and July. The first class is Before You Quit, the masterclass. I have an ebook called Before You Quit, Think About This. It tells anyone who wants to quit their job several things that you should think about before you leave your job or career. Because I've been 2 years in entrepreneurship, and boy, did I need everything discussed in that ebook. Well, now there is a class for that. Another class that I'll be launching is Emotional Intelligence and Emotional Etiquette. Super amazing. Another class is Who Am I? How to Create the Life You Want. Another class is Getting Started and Staying Consistent with Social Media. We also have Spiritual and Mental Emotional Etiquette and Choosing Your Battles Personally and Professionally. Listen, these topics are all things that I have experienced, gone through, and I want to help others understand it as well, especially the course on emotional intelligence and emotional etiquette. I think it's so needed, so necessary, and I cannot wait to bring these courses to you. So yes, visit carapresley.com, check out my Mastermind memberships. There's also one class available that you can view right now without a membership. It's called The Successful Mindset. It gives you an insight into how I instruct, how I teach. Definitely check it out. I appreciate you guys for listening. You are now tuned in to ESPN 106.1, number one in business radio, the Kara Presley Radio Show, in partnership with Mike King. And I appreciate you all. If you're online, follow me on social media. On Instagram, I am The Career Cheerleader. On Facebook, I am The Career Cheerleader. On TikTok, I'm Feeling Successful. And on YouTube and Twitter, I'm Kara Presley, CaraPressley. I love y'all to life. Y'all have a successful day. Stay tuned. Next week, we'll be back again.